I got the DNA test, and I just wanted
Devin,
to say,
just open it. What does it say? Positive. 99% positive.
Tracy, can we at least talk about it?
What do you want to talk about? You want to talk about how you slept with another woman while we were married? Is that a good subject? No, maybe we could talk about if that wasn't pain enough. Now I got to find out you got a kid by that woman. What do you want to talk about? Please tell me. What do you have to say to me?
You're right. I don't have anything to say except that I love you and I don't want to lose you.
Heard that one before. You know, Devin, we've been through a lot. And I don't think we're gonna rebound from this one.
Tracy, we are in our 8th year of marriage. That's a long time to just give up now. I mean, I know things are the way they are, but that doesn't change what we have and what we've created.
For me, it does.
Tracy, you just said that we've gone through a lot, and when things seem like they could get worse, we've always managed to push through it. I mean, we can get past this, baby.
Wait, we can get past this. We can get past this. Yeah, right? That is actually really funny.
What's funny?
You! You are funny! You're gonna stand there and tell me, let's get past this. You're the one who messed up. But you know what? You are really good at just getting past things.
Tracy.
What? Do you want to talk about how you got past all the love and trust that we built to sleep with another woman? You were asking me to get past all of my emotions and my feelings and just accept it. Accept that you slept with another woman and had a baby by her. But you know what? We both know if the shoe was on the other foot, you would be putting your fists through walls, ranting and raving. No. Oh, you know what you'd be doing? You'd be out trying to find another woman to sleep with to ease the pain of your bruised ego.
Tracy, that is not what I'm saying.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that it happened a long time ago. I mean, I was young. I was naive. Tracy, when it happened, I felt so bad that I knew it could never, ever happen again.
You just don't even get it, do you? Let me tell you about how a woman loves a man, Devin. A woman's love, that supersedes any dime he may or may not have in his pocket. That supersedes living conditions that she desires for herself and for her family. I went to work. I went grocery shopping. I cooked your meal. I served your meal. Then I cleaned up. Then I did the dishes, and I folded your clothes, I put them in the drawer, and then I went into a room, and I made you feel like the king that you desired to be, because I loved you. But you know what, honey? That wasn't just there. That was built on the fact that you love me, too.
And I still do, and that hasn't changed, and it never will.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you're right. If it was me, I probably wouldn't be able to take it. But Tracy, you have to understand that I was young. I had just gotten to the league and I got caught up.
Okay, so what, you can't think for yourself?
No, I can. I just got caught up and for nothing more than that. And now that I'm in this situation, nobody else put me here. I put myself here. I did this all to myself. But now I'm in this situation. I have a responsibility to you, my wife, whom I love, and a responsibility to a child who deserves to know who her father is. Now, I'm not saying I have all the answers, but what I am saying is that if you're not in my life, then everything that I've worked for means absolutely nothing. Tracy, all I'm asking you to do is give me a chance to make this right.
I'm I'm sorry, I don't know that that's possible. I just need space, Devin.
Space?
Space.
How much space are we talking
about? As much as I want. A week, a month. You know, maybe permanent.
What are you talking about? And Tracy, stop this. This kind of stress is not good for the baby.
The baby?
Yes.
You know what, honey? I don't think you need to worry about that. It doesn't really matter.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying I don't think I'm gonna keep it.
Tracy, don't do this to me.
You know what?
Don't do this to us.
As far as I'm concerned, the damage is done.
Tracy.
Yes, I do.
That was crazy.
Wow. So this is the shop, huh?
Yep.
I mean, are you sure you're okay with me dropping you off here? I mean, I could take you home. That does seem a little more appropriate.
Well, let's just say I was glad you were perusing the neighborhood, because who would think my car would break down the same time as my cell phone? It's crazy.
It can happen. But you sure you're okay with me leaving you here?
Yeah. I'm just gonna use the landline and call Roger to come get me.
Okay, I get it. He doesn't like me, does he?
Well, let's just say you're not his favorite person. I made the mistake of telling him that we used to date, and now he thinks we're gonna have feelings for each other again.
Well, if he knows you like I know you, he doesn't have anything to worry about, Michelle. You wouldn't do nothing like that.
Well, I wish you'd tell Roger that. I mean, sometimes it feels like we don't even know each other.
How long you two been dating?
Oh, about 5 years.
Whoa, 5 years, wow.
Wow. What?
I mean, 5 years, that's just a long time. I mean, you and I wouldn't have lasted that long.
Well, that's a thing to say.
No, I'm not saying it like that. I'm not saying it like that. I'm just saying we wouldn't have lasted that long because by then, you'd have been my wife.
Stop playing. You're just saying that.
No, I'm telling you, I'm not saying it. Look, I've always recognized that trait in you, Michelle. I mean, not a lot of women have that. I mean, there's a lot of good-looking women, but they're not good for you.
Well, that's funny you say that now that another man has me. Oh. Yeah, so where were those words at when, you know, you and I were dating?
They were there. I was just too young to express it. You know, I didn't know how to express it. I mean, the truth is, when you and I separated, I've always tried to mimic what we had. So much that I married the wrong person.
Really?
Yeah, I was a fool for trying to keep that relationship going, but I did, and what should have been a happily ever after ended up being me in a depression.
So what happened, Reggie?
Well, what happened was I came home to an empty house and a note. The next time her and I had any conversation, it was in the form of a divorce. I mean, she left me for another guy, I mean, with no explanation.
Can I ask you a question? How do you know when you're with the wrong person?
Same way you know when you're with the right person. You just know it.